Hi, I'm Rima Pawar, Senior Director, Product Management Team with IDCS. In this session, I will be giving you an overview of Oracle's Identity Cloud Service, how it is competitively positioned. We'll walk through some use cases, highlighting some recently launched features, and I'll give you a glimpse into what's in the pipeline as well. But before, let's take a look at the market trend in security and identity and what really customers are asking for. Digital transformation is a business imperative in today's environment to remain competitive. Now, Gartner estimates that by 2021, brands that redesign the way they interact with their customers, embrace new technologies to bring innovation faster to market, will see an increase in revenue by 30%. Classic example, Walmart, that grew its online e-commerce business by 40% in 2019. So as these businesses adopt cloud, it's not surprising to note what they really need: a great user experience, which will help them connect directly to their customers, a global brand that operates everywhere around the world and are mandated by regulatory compliances to adhere to. With threat landscape changing every day, a more context-aware adaptive security, and finally, ability to deploy and operate in a heterogeneous environment. Now, interestingly, customers are adopting cloud in a hybrid fashion, right? This is how hybrid cloud and hybrid IAM are becoming a reality. Now, for example, now enterprise can run and deploy on-premise private cloud to host sensitive or critical workloads, but uses a third-party public cloud provider to host less critical resources, such as test and development workloads. Now, in such an environment, where there is a mix of on-prem, private cloud, public clouds, hybrid identity and access management is taking a center stage. So having understood really what the market trend is, what customers are looking for, let's take a look at what IDCS has to offer and how it stands out from the rest. First key differentiator for the Oracle's Identity Cloud Service is it's a microservice-based architecture. It's architected for cloud consumption. All the features are exposed via REST-based APIs. It is based on open and standard-based. For example, it uses or it supports SAML and OpenID Connect and OAuth for authentication, SCIM for user and group management in the cloud. So this IDCS service that we have built is architected for the cloud, taking into account all the cloud pertinent features such as scalability, reliability, high availability, disaster recovery, performance, resilience, etc. The second key differentiator is its ability to meet customers' hybrid IAM requirement. As we've just seen, we just learned how our customers today are not just going with a monolithic model, but they have a pretty hybrid environment. IDCS enables enterprises in the following ways. One, it enables complete hybrid SSO to cloud and on-prem apps applications without having to modify the extensive existing VAM endpoints. So guess what? Customers can leverage their existing VAM investments. Second, it allows flexible options to manage identities in the cloud by either synchronizing identities directly with Active Directory or Oracle's OIG, or by federating authentications to an external identity provider. Many enterprises like to centralize all access management in a central identity provider. In such cases, IDCS can help defer authentication to those external providers, whether it is Oracle's Access Manager, ADFS, or any other such provider. The third most important feature in a hybrid environment is IDCS enables enterprises to extend their governance workflows to the cloud. many enterprises use valuable audit and compliance capabilities for on-premise applications on OIG, such as audit reports, access review certifications, and segregations of duty. Now, enterprise can extend those capabilities to the cloud applications via OIM connector for IDCS. These reports can now be generated for cloud apps using the same familiar interface of OIM and end users and administrators are familiar with. Finally, let's look at the third key differentiator. Oracle's Identity Cloud Service is the identity service that powers the Oracle Cloud. We have paid very close attention to security design from the outset, with adherence to fundamental security design principles for zero trust. Each separate component of the design must authenticate and authorize to access another service. We never store customers' information in CLEAR and follow strict key management processes. IDCS is built for meeting the cloud principles of scalability resilience, which I just spoke to. It's a multi-tenant service with a global coverage. It is built to meet the needs of Oracle's infrastructure as service, platform as service, and software as service applications that rely on IDCS for their identity and access management. Next, what I want to really do is walk you through some of the key use cases of IDCS. The most common use case of IDCS is its ability to provide extensible cloud directly to manage internal as well as external users. App catalog that provides app templates to over 200 odd apps. Very streamlined application onboarding wizards for bespoke apps. And finally, synchronization with multiple sources of identities, be it on-prem or on cloud. The next use case is about the IAM functionality, the hybrid functionality. Most recent release of App Gates provide hybrid SSO to on-prem apps, such as JD Edwards, PeopleSoft, SAP, etc. Recently, we also launched EBS Asserter that allows SSO to EBS without the need for an OIM or OID. Connectors to OIM to manage Oracle Cloud identities, and various APIs are planned to directly integrate with OIM as necessary. Here's a pictorial representation of really how IDCS integrates with all the on-prem applications. As you can see, the third-party apps or Oracle's PeopleSoft e-business suites can directly connect to IDCS. Even the Active Directory can directly sync into IDCS using the bidirectional AD sync. And we also have all the on-prem, the OIM OID that can be connected to, synced to the IDCS as well. The next use case, IDCS allows customers to manage software as service applications, both cloud as well as on-prem apps, with permissions using HCM and AD groups. IDCS allows for role-based access management and account lifecycle management of all these apps, be it on-prem or be it cloud software as services apps. In the next use case, we're talking about IDCS receiving user feeds from users, devices, apps, different applications from Oracle Cloud and external risk engines, perform risk evaluation, and highlight vulnerabilities and provide recommendations. This is one of the key differentiators for IDCS, the adaptive functionality which we have recently launched. Additionally, IDCS also enables conditional user and application authentication policies based on risk and context. If you look at this picture, really, the context here is how does IDCS takes information about the user, the group, the app role memberships, or the behavior of a particular identity, the user or the client, and applies various second factor authentications, app specific IDP authentications, multi-factor authentications to the app to provide a better security. The policies can be tuned based upon IP reputation, upon geolocation, geo-velocity, and you can also name the network ranges and define those in your policies. And of course, it takes external feeds from all the CASBs and SIMs. And all this information is processed in IDCS to provide you a secure user authentication and access management solution for your on-prem as well as your cloud assets. In the next use case, this is about IDCS supporting the consumer identity and access management functionality. IDCS supports a rich set of features such as out-of-the-box and custom user attributes, self-registration, social logins, and SDKs for building apps on IDCS. If you look at this particular picture, it really explains to you an end-to-end customer experience of how the modern apps are built. I mean, developers can choose to have these modern apps deployed on various platforms, be it your bare metal, on-prem, or in Oracle PaaS services. And they could be using any choice of platform, be it the Node, Java, PHP, .NET, and you name it. It could be consumed by any of the end client devices, such as a desktop, mobile, a self-service agent. And all this is supported by IDCS with a 99.95% availability, zero downtime, and a security standard complying to all the necessary regulations and compliance need of our customers. The next use case, really we're talking about the enterprise's need to meet regulations such as GDPR and other regulatory compliances. IDCS enables these businesses to control which users can access which apps using role-based and other techniques. And IDCS also allows customers to enforce privacy while complying with regulations. Here's a quick snapshot of the ways customers can customize the terms of use for their said apps and services to meet all the regulatory compliance needs. The next use case is pretty critical, and I want all of us to understand the fact that IDCS is the service that is powering our Oracle Cloud as well. Customers who get an account with Oracle Cloud today have an access to free foundation features from IDCS by default. This new IDCS-powered cloud account enables easy onboarding of applications, providing access to multiple identity tenancies to meet their customer requirements, which is a new feature recently launched. Under universal credits, all infrastructure as services and platform as services natively integrate with IDCS. Customers can also automatically configure federation with Fusion apps and all the other Oracle software as service applications. And finally, IDCS makes a critical element of the Oracle SOC fabric with tight integration with Oracle Management Cloud as well. That concludes the use cases. In closing, Oracle's Identity Cloud service is well positioned to meet customers' need to protect their cloud assets, no matter where the application is hosted. And for hybrid customers, it enables all hybrid scenarios as well. With that, thank you folks for watching this session. If you have any questions, feel free to reach us, the IDCS product management team. Certification for security is available at Oracle University site. For more information, visit us online. Thank you.